My name is Denise Baptist. I was in the United States Air Force. I came in the military in 1979. I grew in the military, so it helped me to grow. So I loved it, I enjoyed it. I got out in 1987. I was diagnosed in 2017. I was in a lot of pain. I was in excruciating pain. And the doctors decided, he said, let's do a CAT scan. And then they came back and told me, so you got cancer. I'm like, wow. So, and then I said, well, okay, I had prayed about it because I knew I'm gonna live, okay?
First of all, whenever we think about treatments for cancer patients, we should be thinking about clinical trials. It's part of the standard guidelines for thinking about treatment options. Every standard treatment that we have right now is here because somebody volunteered to try it out. I know Ms. Baptist for many years. She actually participated in a research study that we had here at the Durham VA. The treatment that she got is now considered to be one of the standard treatments for her cancer. It really was like a leap of faith because it was her first treatment and she put a lot of trust in us.
I knew I had to do it. I said, God is my champion and the VA is my hero.
It spoke to her, and she wanted to give something back.
By participating in a clinical trial, a veteran has the potential to impact the care of veterans to come in the future. The treatments that are offered through these clinical trials are the most cutting edge, and there's also a real priority in the VA to focus on precision oncology.
We really try to individualize when a clinical trial may come into play and when it would be the best treatment option. Patients become like family because you're with them so frequently and you're really helping them through a very difficult time.
I truly believe that veterans are getting the most scientifically advanced and innovative trials in the VA system. Veterans are inherently altruistic people. I've learned that many veterans, they really are excited about the opportunity to help further our understanding and help improve the care of others.
My name is Karen Ann Muth, and I was in the Army during the Vietnam era conflict from 1967 through 1969. I was probably about 55 years old, realized that I had gender dysphoria, and I spent about 2 years in therapy to get me ready for the actual transition. I noticed I had some lumps in my neck. So I went to a ear, nose, throat doctor and did a biopsy, and he discovered it was non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, which was, as you might expect, it was devastating to me, being hospitalized and being treated over and over and over. I mean, that's all I did pretty much for most of the 15 years I had the disease.
For Ms. Muth's perspective, she'd been through a lot of treatment before, and so we kind of had a heart-to-heart about what the expectations of treatment were. So that's how we came to find a research study at NIH that was appropriate for her and that I thought was a good fit.
There was some hope that maybe finally this was a potential cure.
She put a lot of trust in us that, you know, yes, I'm going to do something that's part of a research study instead of doing a standard treatment.
I think it was about 2 or 3 weeks later. And then they discovered there was no cancer, period, anywhere. It was all gone. So I was extremely happy about that, so were they. So having gone through the clinical trial, I think it's extremely important to get people enrolled in clinical trials because it provides you with possible new avenues for treatment.
I think she gets a lot of pride from kind of having participated in that.
When you find out you're in remission, no matter when it is, it's totally elation. Just relief. You made it.
I'm just thankful right now that I went in the military because it saved my life. That's why I'm so glad to do this, because I want to be able to help other people get through. And whatever we go through, it's not for us. It's for us to be able to help someone else.